Good afternoon. I'm Hazenberg. I'm here with
Kate Silver.
And you're watching the 2019 WFTDA North American Cup West live from Orem, Utah, brought to you by the Happy Valley Derby Darlins and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. Today we're going to see Sacramento Roller Derby, the Capital Mall Stars taking on Red Stick Roller Derby. Sacramento is from
Sacramento.
Who'd have thought? And they are coming into the tournament, the number 6 seed, and are currently ranked number 47 on the WFTDA. Red Stick Roller Derby is from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and they're entering this playoff the number 11 seed and are 63 in the WFTDA. And now for our rosters, Kate, do you want to tell us who's on Sacramento today?
Sure. Skating for Sacramento, we got 0618 Pink Floyd, 1006 Swifty, 108 Namaslay, 1415 Bird Dog, 17 Rhodes Warrior, 18 Body, 1985 Con Artist, 29 Kista, 327 Naka, 424 Lana Payne, 451 Shockin' Auburn, 606 Ariel the Twister, 67 Rose Villain, 911 Fire Engine, and 970 Narnar Jinx.
And on the lineup for Red Stick Roller Derby All-Stars, 100 Original Sin, 15 Trip Hazard, 29 I'm a Pusher, 36 Sailor Doom, 376 Hot Mess Molly, 411 Fun Size, 5 I Shove Lucy, 511 Machu Picchu, 69 De Napalm Death, 725 Sparkles Fantastic, 76 Little Miss Maggot, 777 Dim Can Cans, 89 Princess Lay It On Ya, and 903 Belasian Bayou.
So I'm really looking forward to this game, Hazenberg. So Sacramento has gone 3-7 on the year, but they're coming off a really strong Big O tournament. They went 2-1 at Big O, coming off a nail biter against Evil, who is in this tournament as well, had a 2-victory. Evil is the 3 seed in this tournament. They also beat Sailor City but lost to Boston. But they had cut their differential in a loss to Boston from nearly 99 points to 15 points. So this Sacramento team came into the season starting kind of slow but has been ramping up and is really looking to extend that win streak.
Red Stick are also on a hot streak. They had one loss this year, and that was also a Big O, which was to Jet City, where they lost by only 40 points. All their other matches they have crushed this year, except for when they played Brew City back in March, when they won by 2 points. That was a nail biter.
So this is really going to be an interesting game to watch. Sacramento likes to play a very kind of big, solid, strong defense. They've got a lot of big blockers that they run. Rose Villain, Kista, Narnar Jinx, they've got this very solid brace two-wall formation they like to run. They have a lot of agility, and I think this is going to pair pretty interesting with this Red Stick team that seems to be smaller in stature but super strong.
You know, I agree. Red Stick are known to basically focus on all their attributes. Like, there may be a lot of small players out there, but every single one of them is as strong as, often as a blocker twice their size. We're lining up for our first jam, so we've got number 1006 Swifty on the line for Sacramento Roller Derby. 725 Sparkles Fantastic with the star for Red Stick. We've got just seconds until the whistle blows. 5 seconds, as the jam timer says. And we are off, both jammers in. Swifty coming through on the inside in his lead jammer.
There was no one from Red Stick there on this inside, able to really just run up that line.
6-9 to Napalm Death attempted to land a hit on her right toward the end. And Sparkles Fantastic stayed on her heels the whole time. So this is a no points for anybody jam.
Whew, that jam just ended as quickly as it started, just out there and going.
1-8 Body with the star for Sacramento. 8-9 Princess Lay It On Ya, ready to jam it up for Red Stick. All of you who are listening at home, don't forget to use hashtag WFTDA Cups when you're tweeting or Instagramming or Facebooking about these tournaments, because we are watching those. So if you want to give us some instant feedback, it's right there.
body able to just find some room, was able to evade some quick hits there by Red Stick and get out for lead.
That's two leads in a row for Sacramento. In a row for Sacramento.
Forearm penalty. Going to send the pivot for Sacramento to the box.
Body trying to get past number 29, I'm a Pusher, and succeeding, putting up 4 points on the board. The first points of this game.
Clockwise direction penalty, sending a Red Stick block to the box. Body just finds some room on the outside, picks up some points for Sacramento.
That is Sailor Doom with the penalty, and this is our first lead change, so everybody grab your beverage and hydrate for our lead change social.
Make sure to hydrate.
We got number 411, Fun Size, up to the jam line for Red Stick with 1006, Swifty for Sacramento. Swifty's second time on the jam line. This is only jam three, four?
Three, jam, yep. Jam it three. Three. So Swifty trying to run it tighter on the jammer rotation. Let's see how they hold that up and play it out for the rest of this game.
And Swifty comes through on the outside, grabs the lead position. Fun Size comes around the back, passes. Looks like she's attempting to pass the star to 7-6 Little Miss Maggot. But the star pass is unsuccessful, and Fun Size earned a track cut penalty and is off to the box. So this is now a power jam for the team from California.
Swifty gets through for another four. First four she's had. Forearms penalty, sending the pivot from Sacramento to the box. That's Con Artist. And Swifty now getting sent to the box on a track cut.
Which means that Fun Size is released immediately.
This one's going to go the full two.
And Fun Size was standing up, so she had almost burned through her whole penalty.
Star pass now to number 76.
Little Miss Maggot.
Jigs.
Yep. I'll buy you a Coke later. 4 points in the sky for Little Miss Maggot. Red Stick's first points on the board here in Jam 3. And 3 points also from the emergent Swifty, who has returned from the, 4 points rather.
Little Miss Maggot able to cut through that pack really hot, get through it on the outside. And that's the first points for Red Stick that we have in this game.
Maggot has put up 8 points at this point, tying the jam with Swifty. Now it's all coming down to the defense and efficacy thereof. Little Miss Maggot getting recycled back past turn two. Swifty also mired up in a Red Stick wall as the jam comes to its full two-minute conclusion. 4 points picked up by Little Miss Maggot. 2 points picked up by Swifty at the end there. This is a 14-12 game as we go into jam four. Wow, is it only jam four?
It's only jam four.
What a game. 7-2-5, Sparkles Fantastic up to the jam line for Red Stick. 1-8 body with the star for Sacramento.
So this is interesting. So we've just got a two-jammer rotation for Sacramento. No way they're going to be able to keep that up. I'm interested to see what they do and with the rest of their jammer rotation.
Both jammers fighting their way through. Sparky in the back. Body gets up front, gets the lead. Sparky takes a spill, stashes the star. Passes it to 7-6 Little Miss Maggot.
Body getting drugged back there by I Shove Lucy.
Looks like it is not a legal star pass, so Maggot has to return the star to Sparky. And she throws. Oh, beautiful catch from Sparkles Fantastic. That's the first time I've ever seen that happen. Let me tell you. Sparkly is through to complete her initial. Body getting pushed back by number 5, I Shove Lucy. Recycled all the way back to turn one.
So Sacramento really able to open up some ins and out, not fully for Body. Really nice offensive play by Rhodes Warrior. Allowed Body to run up and grab that 4 points. Bringing the total 18-12, Sacramento.
4-2-4, Lana Payne with the star now for Sacramento as an official review is called by Sacramento. And 8-9, Princess Leia Anya stepping up to the jam line for Red Stick, but I guess they're going to take a minute here. And while we've got a little time to pay the bills here. We got Rydell in the house. I want to give them a big, huge thank you for bringing all the cool skate gear that we've got. Radar wheels, Rydell skates.
Shout out to our officials that we have at this tournament: Neutron Scar, Momster Mash, Zoonontic, Irma Gerd, Jurassic Snark, D. Molly Shore, Rabbit Derby Fan, Margie Ram, Sister Violence, Rex Blocker, Dr. Math, Bibbidi Bobbidi Boom, Dylan, Lil Tex, Richie Cranium, Wookie Mistake, X-Ray Ted, and Recordian.
Looks like we are getting ready to hear from our head ref here.
Explaining the outcome of the review.
Sacramento was asking for an illegal procedure for the star throw, but no call stands. Sacramento loses their official review. Once again, we've got Lana Payne on the jam line for Sacramento. And 8-9 Princess Lay It On Ya jamming for Red Stick.
First time we've had Lana Payne take the star for Sacramento.
Princess gets out front, but she gets a cut in the process. So this is a power jam for Sacramento as Lana Payne comes back around turn one and engages with the Red Stick defense and slices right through to put up 4 points.
Yeah, Lana Payne was able to find some room on the outside for some quick offense.
Sacramento has gotten lead in every jam in this game so far.
Only able to pick up three there. Looks like a no pass, no penalty.
2 points.
Miss a point. Excuse me, two, yes.
One, 1-0-0-6 Swifty up to the jam line now for Sacramento. Princess Lay It On Ya still in the penalty box.
Swifty coming up, this is her third time jamming.
And Swifty gets through on the inside, grabs the lead.
Track cut sends Kisa to the box.
Machu Picchu, 6-9 to Napalm Death, 1-0-0 Original Sin, just giving Swifty hell.
Swifty looking for some offense on the outside. Pink Floyd is enough of a distraction. It gets knocked there out on the front by Little Miss Maggot.
And Swifty almost gets free, but takes another hit from 6-9 to Napalm Death and is forced to call off the jam. Still picking up 4 points on her way out, though.
We need to roll quick, think quick, quick bearings, where precision meets performance.
Get number 411, Fun Size, on the jam line for Red Stick with 1-0-8, Namaslay putting on the star for Sacramento.
First time we see Namaslay on the line, and so this jammer rotation has been pretty interesting for Sacramento this far.
Red Stick running a 3-jammer rotation currently. We'll see how that continues as Coach Jan Scullivan adapts to his strategy. Namaslay is out and is lead, continuing Sacramento's unbroken lead streak.
Namaslay doing a really good job cutting in and out, able to distract that Red Stick defense enough to pop through on turn one.
And we had a star pass on Red Stick, 7'6", Little Miss Maggot, who is the go-to pivot for Red Stick in this game.
Second star pass to Little Miss Maggot in this game thus far. Both star passes from fun size.
Now to the jam line for Red Stick, 7'25", Sparkles Fantastic, and for Sacramento, number 1-8, Body. Pushing her way up to the front, Body getting mired up in the back, but sliding on through.
Ooh.
Getting held down by Little Miss Maggot, and Sparkles Fantastic gets out front and is your lead jammer.
Sparkles first, Fantastic, first lead.
First Red Stick lead of the game. 6-9 Danae Palm Death off to the box.
There's a little bit of confusion there on the start. It looks like Sacramento rushed to the front, and Red Stick able to take advantage of some of that confusion, get lead real quick.
Sparkles through for 4 points. Body is through for 3. Oh, sorry, Body through for 4, rather. Body through for another 4. Sparky getting recycled back to turn 4.
Direction sends one of the Red Stick walkers to the box. Red Stick out there with a micro pack now. Body taking an advantage of it. 8-6 jam, Sacramento.
Yep, only 2 Red Stick blockers on currently remaining on the track. It's going to be 7-6 Little Miss Maggot, 1-0-0 Original Sin, as number 424 Lana Payne steps up to jam for Sacramento, and 8-9 Princess Lay It On You puts on the star for Red Stick.
Official timeout
being called.
Radar Wheels, WFTDA Continental Cups are brought to you by Radar Wheels. Radar Halo, experience world-class edging. So Hazenburg, interesting, I keep on talking about this jammer rotation. I think I'm doing it because one of the key jammers that is part of Sacramento's lineup, Ariel Twister, doesn't seem to be skeeting yet. Although now we're seeing her come to the bench. So maybe this was a travel issue, or you know, I might speculate wildly, but you know, this is as one would do in the profession. But so far, relying more on Namaste, Swifty, Body, and Lana Payne mixing up that jammer rotation. Meanwhile, Red Stick came in this tighter 3 jammer rotation. But the jammer rotation Sacramento has been working for them so far. 40-18, 11 minutes into this game.
All right, number 8-9, Princess Lay It On You jamming. 4-2-4, Lana Payne jamming for Sacramento. Princess Lay It On You getting the lead.
This micro pack just let both of these jammers go really quickly.
And we've got a washing machine pack right now as they just go through the spin cycle here.
Sacramento just rushing this up, probably to try to free some of those blockers from the box.
No points for anybody. This is the first scoreless game jam since the first jam. Oh no, sorry, third scoreless jam so far. 4-1-1 fun size up to the jam line for Red Stick.
That's Ariella Twister, as I mentioned, just got to the bench.
Yeah, just speaking about her. And there she is, 6-0-6 Ariella Twister.
Ears must have been burning, knew we were talking about her.
Twister almost gets through on the inside, takes a big hit from 5-1-1 Machu Picchu. Fun size taking a big hit from 1-7 Rhodes Warrior. The Ariella Twister is out and gets the lead position. Fun size struggling on the pivot line.
Ariella Twister taking advantage of some quick O from Pink Freud. Oh, and laying a big hit there on a Red Stick blocker.
4 points in the sky for Sacramento.
Same move there, big hit there by Kista, and just having to deal with one in the front. So this seems to be Ariel's MO right here. Although looking from the inside there, doesn't get it. Oh, yeah, she does. Pops out through, gets another 4 points.
And the star has been passed on Red Stick once again to number 7-6, Little Miss Maggot. This is her third time receiving a star pass in this game. Maggot attempts an apex jump, but takes a spill. Looks like that run hurt a little bit. Still pulled up 1 point for Red Stick as the jam came to its end. Ariella Twister putting up two more. That's a 14-point jam. Highest scoring single jam of the game so far. 7-2-5 Sparkles Fantastic up to the jam line for Red Stick. 1-0-0-6 Swifty up to the line for Sacramento. Team timeout being called by Red Stick now.
The Rydell Solaris, the performance you demand, the comfort you've been missing. See what everyone is talking about and visit roller.rydellskates.com/Solaris. Visit their booth if you're in the venue to learn more about the Solaris.
Red Stick's head coach, James P. Scullivan, is going to put his head together with the skaters and see if they can reformulate their strategy.
So Ariella Twister coming into this game now. First jam, putting up 14 and doing a really good job. The way Ariel tends to skate, has that really good speed control, is able to look for that offense, take it, and then deal with one by using her lateral footwork or taking a line and just jumping right over it.
Absolutely. Let's see, we've got some fun bits in hashtag WFTDA Cups. Treble says, throwing and catching in Derby, no thanks. No hand-eye coordination, hashtag whip to the cups, WFTDA Cups. Sacramento starting strong with 2 lead jam status. Rose Villain is playing. And we've got some folks noting that Little Miss Maggot has been jamming quite extensively. Or not jamming, but playing quite extensively. It's 7-2-5 Sparkles Fantastic now, jamming for Red Stick with 1-0-0-6 Swifty jamming for Sacramento. Swifty blazes through, gets the lead.
Directional sends, I think that's Narnard Jinx in the box. Oh, excuse me. Well, I cannot tell who that is sitting in the box. Rose Villain. It looks like Swifty's being sent to the box for a forearm penalty.
Oh, so this is a power jam in favor of Red Stick. I gotta say, if I had to make a list of jammers I wouldn't want to give up a power jam to, Sparkles Fantastic would be right at the top of that list. 4 points in the sky for Red Stick. 5-1-1 Machu Picchu off to the box. One of Red Stick's blockers.
Sparky's such a productive jammer for Red Stick. We're seeing so much work coming out of her in this game. Just had a phenomenal tournament at Big O this year.
Red Stick's bench singing the hot jammer chant to let them know that Swifty is back out of the box.
And a big hit there. Narnar Jinx has had laid a huge hit there, but gets sent to the box with a high block. Oh no, and a back block sending Swifty back to the penalty box.
So it's a double power jam for Red Stick. And Sparkle's Fantastic absorbing hit after hit on her way through.
Sparky getting around one. One left in Con Artist.
There we go. That is the highest scoring single jam so far for Red Stick. Penalty box is emptied out. Swifty rejoining the track. And that was a 14-point jam total for Red Stick, 3 points for Sacramento.
So that's a bit of a penalty parade. Sacramento hemorrhaging people to the box and having a double power jam played against them. So Red Stick really able to take advantage of just people leaving the track.
This has been an extremely clean game so far. Just a double handful of penalties picked up by both teams. We got 8-9 Princess Leia Anya jamming now for Red Stick with 6-0-6 Ariella Twister with the star for Sacramento and the lead.
2-for-2 for Ariella Twister, able to take advantage. Oh, nice little throws the dummy to the out. Love that term.
4 points picked up by Ariella Twister. And looks like we've had a star pass on Red Stick to 100. 100 original sin. This is the first time a star pass has been made to a pivot that was not Little Miss Maggot.
Ariel LeTwister able to jump the apex there on that pass. Now looking to put more on the board.
Original Sin is a longtime roller derby veteran, having played for Tragic City out of Birmingham, Alabama. Acadiana Roller Derby out of Lafayette, Louisiana, and Atlanta Roller Derby, obviously out of Atlanta, before joining Red Stick.
Now, Ariel LeTwister looks like be a little in a little bit of pain holding her arm in. Might be struggling. We'll see if she keeps on playing in this game.
Number 1-5 Trip Hazard jamming for Red Stick. First time with the star in this game. And we got number 1-8 Body jamming for Sacramento. Trip Hazard getting recycled back to the pivot line. Takes a huge crumpled hit.
Shock and Auburn up at the front, trying to play some offense there for Body. Body gets knocked to the end though and has to recycle back to the start line.
It's like a multiplayer block being called. And Trip Hazard is through, but is not lead. But Body is off to the box, making this a power jam for Red Stick. Hazard slicing through for 4 points.
Now she took the star off, so this is going to go the full two.
Yep, a full 2 minute jam as Hazard puts up another 4 points.
Oh,
Hazard takes a huge hit in turn one. Forced to recycle back to the pivot line. That was number 451, Shock and Auburn, throwing it down.
Yeah, she tried to jump that apex, but it was completely shut down. Then tried to call it off, but she's not lead.
And 1-8 Body is back out of the penalty box and into the fight.
Body knocked to the inside by Little Miss Maggot. Now getting worked back to the start line.
And Hazard threw for another four.
Body not finding a lot of luck, trying to find these lines around this Red Stick defense. Red Stick doing a great job shutting them down and dragging back incredibly quickly.
So that is a 16-point jam for Red Stick. I believe that is now their highest scoring jam. This makes this a 49-72 game in favor of the team from Louisiana.
Paradigm Play and Skate Products, cutting edge designs, cutting edge performance. Part of the Rydell family.
725 Sparkles Fantastic up to the jam line for Red Stick. 606 Ariel LeTwister with the star for Sacramento.
Looks like they're going to keep on putting Ariel in despite her holding arm. Looks like she's holding it in.
Oh, wow.
Just runs up that line, evades a hit completely from Machu Picchu.
It is hard to avoid Machu Picchu when she's on target like did, that. Ariel LeTwister just zips around the pack.
Yes.
Like there's nobody even there. 4 points in the sky. Machu picking up a back block. That is going to be her fourth penalty of this game so far.
And Ariel LeTwister, I just saw that line open for her to do that little apex hop. She's so good at that, able to do it. Coming through, just jocks under the butt of a Red Stick blocker. Gets through for her third scoring pass already in this jam.
We had a star pass to 1-0-0, Original Sin. Original Sin, second time receiving the star in the game. Ariel LeTwister getting out, calls off the jam, 4 points in the sky. That is the highest scoring single jam so far for Sacramento. So we've had two 16-point jams in a row. So that's great.
The sort of style that Ariel plays is that she really likes to take advantage of those gaps in space, giving just 5, maybe even 3 feet, able to juke to the end, run up a line, really make those blockers make those mistakes. So good at that.
8-9 Princess Leia Anya up against 0-6-1-8.
That's Pink Floyd. That's Pink First Floyd. Time we've seen her jam this game.
And Pink Floyd is your lead jammer.
Pink Floyd able to push that Red Stick defense up, then go up the outside there.
And we got a star pass to 7-6 Little Miss Maggot once again.
Pink Floyd gets through. She's been playing double duty in this game so far. Does it well, gets all four, plays it clean.
Calls off the jam. No points for anybody, or no points for anybody on that pass anyway. But 4 points picked up total by Sacramento. As we've got 8 minutes left in our half. 1-5 Trip Hazard back up to the jam line for Red Stick. 1-0-8 Namaslay with the star again for Sacramento.
Now Hazard last time was out, was able to take advantage of that two penalties. I believe that was against Namaslay, went there twice. Or I think that was Swifty actually. Had two penalties in a single jam. Namaslay though gets out first.
Namaslay once again grabbing the lead. I do believe she has a 100% lead percentage.
Stars already off our Hazard. Gets knocked to the outside there by Kista. Slays out, does a spin on the inside. Gets the first four of this jam.
And then a star pass once again to 1-0-0 Original Sin on Red Stick.
Oh, Slay takes advantage of really nice tornado tile style offense by Bird Dog. Gets through for another four.
4-1-1, fun size up to the jam line for Red Stick. 1-0-0-6, Swifty with the star for Sacramento. Fun size has pesky written on the back of her leg.
What's that mean?
One of the Derby bloggers referred to Red Stick as a pesky league a while back.
That's lovely. I was once referred to as shiny.
Can't confirm. Both of these jammers fighting hard to get through, but Fun Size ultimately prevails and gets the lead. Although also a no pass, no penalty somehow.
Stars off there by Swifty. Oh, great job there by Fun Size. Ducks under Narnar Jinx. Woo.
Fun Size slips through, puts up those 4 points. Comes around for another score pass. Swifty getting recycled and then diving into the Red Stick defense while Fun Size tries to find her way around the big blue wall that is Sacramento. They've had a star pass on Sacramento. I think it's Sacramento's first star pass today. The 1985 Gone Artist.
Yeah, and Swiftiness finding no purchase there. Trying to test those lines. Red Stick doing a really good job of shutting them down, dragging Sacramento's jammers back.
We've had 5 star passes in the last 6 jams. Oof. And 7-6 Little Miss Maggot off to the penalty box for the second time in this game. 5-1-1 Machu Picchu has 5. Nobody else on Red Stick has more than 1. On Sacramento, 2 skaters have 3 penalties. 1 skater has 4. Everyone else is 1 or nothing. And we've got 8-9 Princess Leia Anya jamming for Red Stick. 6-0-6 Ariel the Twister jamming for Sacramento. Looks like 6-9 Denapalm Death has figured out the secret to holding her back, but it doesn't stop her from getting through and getting that lead, because Denapalm Death got a penalty in the process.
Yeah, Denapalm Death doing some nice one-on-one work, but a little too aggressively in the wrong direction. Ariel the Twister, 4-for-4 for leads. Easily glides through, already putting up 8 points 40 seconds into this jam. Oh,
wow! Ariel the Twister getting some aerial twisting happening. 4 points in the sky as a result. And Little Miss Megan's out of the box, has received the star and a track cut. So she's going to go sit down for a little bit longer. Ariel LaTwister gets out, puts up four more points, calls it off.
And Ariel LaTwister doing such a good job, so good track awareness. You can tell her by those signature orange suede skates, which are Rydell skates. Make your own skates with these, your own custom color, handcrafted Color Lab boots by Rydell Skates.
It was a 16-point jam there for Ariel LaTwister. So once again, nobody has broken 16 points in this game so far. 1-0-0-6 Swifty jamming for Sacramento with 7-6 Little Miss Maggot jamming for Red Stick that's sitting in the box.
Failure to reform penalty
on Sailor Doom.
Fire Engine and Sailor Doom in the box.
And only one Red Stick blocker currently in the track right now.
So what happened there is that Sacramento ran back to try to force the no pack call. Didn't reform quickly enough on either side. That's why both of these teams just lost blockers right away.
And Swifty threw for four more points. Little Miss Maggot out of the box along with 1-0-0 Original Sin. This is Maggot's first time starting a jam with the star. Swifty threw for another four.
Swifty doing a really good job with that decreased blocker volume, having much more success than she had on the last time she was out.
And Swifty threw again. A penalty box has emptied out, so we're going to have a full pack on our next jam. That was a 16-0 jam in favor of Sacramento, 135-56, 2 minutes left in the half. 7-2-5, Sparkles Fantastic up to the line for Red Stick. 4-2-4, Lana Payne with the star for Sacramento.
Red Stick not really finding their footing so far in this game in terms of defense. Having some good individual play, but they're not finding each other, and Sacramento's really able to take advantage of that.
And Sparkles Fantastic is your lead jammer.
Lena Payne right behind her. Able to force the call off. 0-0 jam. Minute and a half. Only the fourth scoreless jam in this game.
Number 411, Fun Size, coming up to the jam line for Red Stick with 108 Namaste jamming for Sacramento.
Narnar Jinx throwing Fun Size, Fun Size out to the in.
But Namaste gets through to get the lead. Fun Size has also escaped the pack.
Rose Villain getting sent to the box on a forearms. Namaste calling it off, able to put up three.
Just 20 seconds left in our half here, so this will be the last jam of the half. 1-5 Trib Hazard with the star for Red Stick. Looks like 6-0-6 Ariel LaTwister coming out for Sacramento. I really hope whatever's going on with her arm, she doesn't make it worse by doing this.
Yeah, I imagine it's arm. I mean, it's hard to tell from here. I think I know what's going on. I do not want to wildly speculate about an injury.
No, indeed. It's the skater's business. It's not ours.
Yeah.
But Trip Hazard is your lead hazard. I mean, jammer.
I mean, she is a lead hazard.
That she is. And she is grinding into that pack. Red Stick with the brace two all to hold back Ariel LaTwister. But now 6-7, Rose Villain coming out of the box to break up the formation.
I think this is the first time Ariel LaTwister hasn't got lead in this game.
I believe you're correct on that one. That is correct. Can confirm.
Bobby Narkar, producer, seeing us those hot stats.
Giving us the hot goss. Four points picked up by Trip Hazard. As we go into halftime, scores are 138-60 in favor of Sacramento. All right, Kate, wow, what a first half that was.
There's a lot happening in the first half. So we had that back and forth in terms of the jammer rotation from Sacramento going between Body and Swifty, introducing some Namaslay and Lana Payne. Ariel LaTwister comes in halfway through, throws up those 16-point jams, and we've had multiple ones from multiple Sacramento jammers throughout the game so far. Red Stick, though, running into some penalty trouble. We have Machu Picchu on 5 and a few other folks on 3 and 2. So that Red Stick defense not able to hold back those Sacramento jammers as well as they'd like to.
You know, I agree, but we will see how their strategies adapt on our second half here, and we will be back with you in a few moments. We're going to pay some bills while we have our halftime. Welcome back to the WFTDA North America, WFTDA Continental Cups North America West here live in Orem, Utah. My name is Hazenberg.
I'm Gate Silver.
And you are watching Sacramento versus Red Stick. Wow, what a first half that was, Kate. Do you want to give us some of the stats rundowns on that?
Absolutely, Hazenberg. So Sacramento, 16 leads in that first half, one star pass, but 4 jammer penalties. In terms of top scores, Ariel LaTwister with 57 points and Swifty with 33 points. Meanwhile, Red Stick has 5 leads, has done 8 star passes, and has 3 jammer penalties. Now, I want to say that 42 of Red Stick's 60 points have been on Sacramento power jams that they have given up. Okay, so Red Stick really needs to be able to take advantage and get those leads, start putting those points on the board, not wait until they have those opportunities for those Sacramento jammers to mess up and go to the box. So let's see what kind of changes they've made in the half to ensure that they can get back into this game and get back onto the board.
Well, it's going to all come down to the bench coaches with their strategies on this one. So we'll see how both of them have adapted to each other as we get back into it. Looks like lining up for the first jam of this second half, number 606, Ariel LaTwister for Sacramento, and 7-6 Little Miss Maggot with the star for Red Stick. This is Maggot's second time starting with the star. The first time was after she had received a star pass and then got a penalty, and then the jam came to an end, so she had to start the next one.
Now, Maggot's scored 13 points in this game so far, but has the largest point differential with negative 47. So, putting her out, she may have more successful starting off the line rather than playing at a deficit, having taken those star passes. And if you got something to say to us, you know where to find us. Hashtag WFTDA Cups. And we'll see what you say on the Twitters.
That we will. And the whistle is blown and off they go. Some strong defense happening on the part of both teams here. Little Miss Maggot almost makes it out front, but gets recycled. But through the opening that she made to come back in, Ariel LaTwister dived through and grabbed the lead. Maggot also escaped seconds after and is approaching the back of the pack. Ariel LaTwister calling it off from the middle, picking up 2 points for Sacramento.
Ariel LaTwister just finding those holes, able to bust through. Connard's doing a really good job shutting down the inside line so Little Miss Maggot doesn't get through and get lead.
1006 Swifty with the jam, or with the star rather, for Sacramento. 725 Sparkles Fantastic jamming for Red Stick on this one.
Sparkles, the lead jammer, lead point scorer in the first half for Red Stick with 20 points.
And the jam is off. They are going. Once again, we're seeing this extremely thick and tenacious defense that we saw in the previous jam. And we've got a penalty issued to number 5, Aisha Lucy, as Swifty gets out, puts up the lead.
Swifty able to take advantage of some of the little confusion in the scrum that formed around turn 2.
That was Aisha Lucy's first penalty of the game. Swifty through as well as Sparky.
Swifty really nicely able to stay in bounds, just using those outside edges to maintain, get those 4 points and call it off.
1985 Con Artist also picking up a penalty at the end of the jam there as the whistle's blown. No points picked up for anybody on that pass, but 4 points picked up by Sacramento total on the jam.
Rydell Skates, innovative leader in roller skates for over 70 years.
1-5 trip hazard with the star for Red Stick.
The trip had that huge jam. Biggest jam of the game for Red Stick with 16 points, but she was able to take advantage of that off a power jam opportunity. Let's see how she does just doing it in this jam.
1-8 body with the star for Sacramento getting recycled. As Trip Hazard is your lead jammer.
She does a little barrel roll out of the pack there. He's to head now to the box.
Bonnie making her way through to complete her initial as Hazard picks up 4 points. Second elbow penalty picked up by, or forearm penalty rather, picked up by 100 original sin.
So this is an interesting thing. Machu Picchu on the line for Red Stick. She's sitting on 5 penalties right now, and they're giving her the star. That's a sketchy decision at best.
108 Namaste wearing the star for Sacramento. And as you mentioned, this is Machu's first time with the star in this game. And she is close to fouling out. Namaste gets the lead. Machu's right behind her.
Maslay weaves, tries to take advantage of a little offensive maneuver on the out, able to pick up the full 4 and hold Machu Picchu to 0.
4-2-4, Lana Payne picking up the star for Sacramento. 4-1-1, Fun Size also jamming now for Red Stick.
Carla or Spindy on Twitter saying, that's my captain, Hazard is killing it on the jam line.
That is Spindiana Jones, one of Red Stick's B-team skaters for the Capital Defenders.
What a fantastic name.
Da-da-da-da.
Da-da-da. Forearm's going to send a Red Stick blocker to the box.
903 Blasian Bayou. Lana Payne picks up the lead. 4-1-1 Fun Size still trying to make her way through.
Lana Payne does a nice little feign to the end, able to get through, pick up all 4. Pink yeah. Freud knocks Fun Size to the end, but no pass, no penalty. Illegal contact, though, sending Pink Freud to the box.
4 points picked up by Sacramento as Lana Payne calls it off from the floor. Looks like she's having a little talk with referee Dr. Math there.
Go faster, farther, and smoother with precision bearings from Quick.
Arielle the Twister, number 606, up to the line for Sacramento. 7-6 Little Miss Maggot jamming for Red Stick.
Oh, Little Miss Maggot almost getting through. It gets knocked to the out by Con Artist. Oh, illegal contact there. Since the Sacramento block to the box, Air Little Twister rolls out of the pack.
Looks like 376 Hot Mess Molly took a big hard hit there. Ariel the Twister going off to the box for a track cut, making this a power jam for Red Stick as Sacramento only has 2 blockers left on the track. And Red Stick has a full pack.
I want to say that's Ariel the Twister's first penalty in this game.
That is correct. Little Miss Maggot coming through for her second scoring pass. Tingy hit from 0618 Pink Freud.
Forearms penalty. Sending Con Artist to the box. Arrow Twister coming back into the fray.
Maggot picked up 4 points. Knocked over her own teammate, number 6'9", to Napalm Death.
Arrow Twister already threw her 4. Able to slice through the pack. Oh, great hit there. by 69.
That's to Napalm Death.
Nice.
And Maggot picking up another 4 points on her way through, as well as 4 points for Ariella Twister. Maggot's ahead by four on this jam.
Ariella Twister splits the seas, gets through for four.
Tying up the jam.
Looks like that was some weirdness near the end, sending someone to the box. Low block, gonna send the Napalm Death to the box. Ariella Twister puts up 12. Little Miss Maggot able to put up 13.
That is Napalm Death's third penalty of the game so far.
And Connard is sitting on six now. Critical piece of the Sacramento defense. So let's see how she fares through the rest of these 22 minutes of the game.
And now we got Swifty versus Sparky again. Sparkle's fantastic, number 725 versus Swifty, number 1006.
High block sends keys to the box. Swifty through now, lead jammer Sacramento.
That's four lead jams in a row picked up by Sacramento.
Swifty's able to pick up three, really able to do the thing that she did in her last jam. Really nice edge work, able to hang on that edge, duck under some butts, get through for those points.
Just zip, zip, zipping along. 1-5 Trip Hazard with the star for Red Stick. 1-0-8 Namaste with the star for Sacramento.
An official time out.
A little OTO.
Hazenburg, this is the first of the WFTDA postseason. We've got a lot more postseason play.
We have
the Continental Cup. That's the North America East Cup. That's in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. We've got the Continental Cup in Europe, which is in, where, remind me where this is. This is in Helsinki, Finland. We got the International WFTDA Playoffs in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And then we have the Seattle playoff. And then the grand finale in Montreal, Canada. The first international, the first WFTDA championships happening outside of the U.S. I'm really excited for that one.
Oh, I'm so excited. I'm not going to be able to make that one in person, unfortunately, but I will get my watch pass from WFTDA.tv, and you can bet we're having a party at Hazen's place.
Hazen party, what's up?
Hashtag Hazenburg party.
you'll be cooking there.
You're gonna love my product, I promise. Number 1-5 Trip Hazard with the star for Red Stick, 1-0-8. Namaste jamming for Sacramento.
Namaste takes advantage of some of the speed, able to get out first for lead jammer for Sacramento. Hazard through now, star off.
It's been a while since Red Stick has been able to play against somebody who can match them or even surpass them in terms of agility.
Yeah, this Sacramento team is really tall. They're really fast. They have the strength and speed, really able to take that negative space away from those jammers and set up some very solid defensive formations.
Now back with the jam line for Red Stick, 5-1-1 Machu Picchu, second time with the star in this game up against 1-8 Body. Once again, a reminder, Machu Picchu sitting on five penalties currently. Meanwhile, Body is only sitting on one.
We've seen Body and Namaste being used less in the second half. Oh, great there. Just shutting down the run back there by Roseville, and Body gets out lead jammer.
Machu Picchu still fighting the back of the Sacramento pack. Looks like track cut being called on 3-6 Sailor Doom.
Body evades a hit from I'm a Pusher, gets four more. And Body avoids a hit, finds a screen on the inside, picks up four more. Eight on the board for Sacramento, brings their total 182-77. 105-point lead.
4-1-1 fun size with the star for Red Stick. Number 1006 Swifty with the star for Sacramento as we go into jam 9 of our second half.
It's really interesting to see Red Stick try these new jammer strategies, giving the star to Machu, giving the star to Little Miss Maggot, seeing what's working against the Sacramento defense, but finding limited success.
And Swifty is through to get the lead position.
Swifty rides the back, rolls around the outside.
Fun size is past the start at 8-9 Princess Lay and Anya. And that is the first time that Princess has received a star pass. Typically, she has been run as a jammer in this game, and she's through for 4 points.
And Princess able to roll off, take advantage of a hit that goes out of bounds and gets through.
It was the first time Red Six picked up points in 4 jams. 4 more points picked up by Swifty.
Multiplayer block sending Pink Floyd to the box.
And Princess picking up 4 more.
Now, Swifty does have lead, and Sacramento's opting to run this one long, which is an interesting strategy. I think they're trying to rely on their defense a bit more to run up the score, but they are the higher-ranked team, so running it long doesn't behoove them if they're playing the rankings game at this moment. They're just matching points here.
They're point for point, 16 for both teams here.
Swifty chooses to call it off, and I gotta say, I'm not quite sure I agree with that call from the Sacramento bench. You're just tiring out your lead score, and this strategy is probably just gonna benefit Red Stick in terms of the ranking game. It's also a questionable strategy if you're trying to win this game. But who am I? I am here, a humble announcer. What can I say about strategy?
We got 725 Sparkles Fantastic up to the jam line for Red Stick. 606 Ariel LaTwister with the star for Sacramento. It's the first time we've seen Ariel with the star in a little while.
We might be taking a break, resting that injury. It's jam number 6.
So first time in 5 jams. Sparky is through first, but picked up a no pass, no penalty, and so did not acquire lead. But Sparky is also now through for 4 points. Ariel LaTwister gets through, gets the lead, calls off the jam just as Sparky was seeming to get warmed up there.
Yeah, so good job by Red Stick taking advantage of that lead, able to put some points on the board.
1-4-1-5 Bird Dog jamming for the first time in this game for Sacramento. 1-5 Trip Hazard with the star for Red Stick.
So both these teams now mixing it up with the jammer rotation, putting some folks who are usually blocking into it. We got an official timeout happening right now. Want to take that to tell you about Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in roller skates for over 70 years. And Powerdyne, if a maneuverable and reactive plate is what you are looking for, then look no further than the Arius Platinum from Powerdyne. Arius Platinum, performance redefined.
And don't forget to use hashtag WFTDA Cups on your posts about this tournament. I don't really do the Instagram, but I am looking at it on Twitter. So either way. All right, this is a track maintenance timeout. So they're going to get some fresh tape out there. It's taking a lot of abuse for this one.
Cup quakes. She says, one-armed Ariel LaTwister showing insane skills, insane. Blowing up inverted blockers, dipping one shoulder into the outside, pure powerhouse. So this is an interesting, I'm interested in particularly why these teams are going with such varied jammer rotation. I think, I mean, Sacramento is in a position where they're mixing up these jammer rotations. They have a solid 3-4, and they're taking people like Bird Dog and putting her out the jam is, I mean, it's an interesting strategy. I think maybe at this point, giving them jammer experience at this level, So I'm interested to kind of know what the reasoning is here. Nonetheless, you know, it's nice to see a variety of jammers on the line out there and playing a variety of roles.
And speaking of Bird Dog, we have her on the jam line again, but she's off to the box on a track cut penalty. Number 15, Trip Hazard, started the jam for Red Stick, but has passed the start at 8-9, Princess Lei and Anya. And so we will have a full two-minute jam, just 15 minutes left in our game. 4 points picked up by Princess Lei and Anya on that pass.
So Princess tries for the middle, her offense going to the out.
Oh, a huge hit delivered to number 5, Aisha Lucy. That looks like that hurt.
Princess tries to find a little bit outside with Bird Dog. Does a really nice move where she's able to contort her body, avoids a hit there at the top, threw on her initial.
A little tornado twist in there. And also Bird Dog straight out of the box and completing her initial like that.
I like this versatility from Bird Dog, spinning and finding some jammer skills here. It's really nice that she's having the chance to exercise those. A illegal contact penalty
on 376.
Hot mess Molly to the box. Bird Dog is spinning and pirouetting in such a way that is making me dizzy from the dais.
Oh, Princess almost makes it through, takes a spill, but doesn't go out of bounds, and so she's able to scooch back up and get through for the points. Bird Dog also hunting down the points.
Let's see what you did there. Eight on the jam. I mean, jam was a bit of a spinny mess near the end there. A few illegal contact penalties after some pack destructions. So we're getting to the point of the game where I think people are kind of you know, losing focus and they're not paying attention to pack. Positional pack penalties account for all 5 of Hot Mess Molly's penalties, and she's sitting in a way that is not helpful for Red Stick.
No, indeed. We got 5-1-1 Machu Picchu jamming for Red Stick against 4-2-4 Lana Payne for Sacramento. We got a track cut on Lana Payne, so this is a power jam for Red Stick as Machu picks up the lead.
Only the second lead for Red Stick this half. Narnar Binks getting sent to the box.
And Machu butts heads with one of the Sacramento blockers, but gets through and puts up 4 points.
Another pack penalty issued to a Red Stick blocker.
That's number 15, Trip Hazard.
You've seen her do a lot of double duty in this game. And Machu Picchu able to shrug off individual hits from Fire Engine. And Rose Villain get through for 4.
Lana Payne is out of the box and mixing it back up with the Red Stick defense, getting recycled back behind turn 4. And then making her way through on the outside to complete her initial.
Oh.
Thrown onto her back. X-ray Ted, one of our referees, also takes a spell.
Everybody hitting the floor there. Machu, Ted, one of the officials that over at Bay Area. We see a lot of them. But a big jam there by Red Stick, 9-0. More pack penalties. All 3 of Hazard's penalties have been pack penalties as well. So Red Stick falling into a bit of penalty trouble with keeping pack, getting to the point in the game where you're exhausted, a really physical game, not able to get together with your friends and make it happen.
606 Ariel the Twister, your lead jammer. 411 Fun Size wearing the star for Red Stick, passing it, or attempting to pass it to 8-9 Princess Lei and Anya.
I love the way Ariel the Twister took full impact into Aisha Lucy, knocked her down, and kept on running up the outside line.
Just, you know, a little casual country stroll on the outside.
That's just some core goals there.
Absolutely. Oh, but a penalty picked up by Ariel LeTwister as a track cut.
I shove Lucy getting a directional.
Looks like they're going to get a chance to talk about that hit.
Discussing it in the box, my favorite pastime.
Fun Size is through for her initial, juking around on the outside to get those 4 points.
That's a third 2-minute jam and a half, sixth of the game. Another penalty sending Amma Pusher to the box. Ariel's back in the action now, putting up a quick four.
Immediately out of the box and through the pack, like it wasn't even there.
Yeah, just like the pack was butter, and she's a hot knife.
And she slid through again, fighting off several hits, including one from 7-6 Little Miss Maggot, who got a penalty for her trouble.
Ariel LeTwister hopping, falling down, but having all limbs in bounds.
4 more points picked up by Ariel LeTwister. It's a 16-point jam for her so far.
Another illegal contact penalty, sending I Shove Lucy to the box.
And that's 20 points picked up by Ariel LeTwister. This is the highest scoring single jam for either team of this game so far.
So just a huge penalty train there for Red Stick. Just penalty after penalty, and all of them positionals.
Now, team timeout being called by Red Stick.
Yeah, when you're at a point like this where you're losing the focus and really need to, you're making those kinds of positional penalties, then I like this call. Call a timeout. See if you can bring it back together. Everyone take some deep breaths and really ensure that.
Or do a little dancing like you guys can see
on the
screen.
They were doing like a little like
wavy arm
palm
dance.
Tree swing. What are
the tube man?
The tube things. Man, yeah. Just
those.
They had one of those at the Rydell booth at RollerCon this year. If you don't know about Rydell skates, they're a proud sponsor of the 2019 WFTDA.
They had one at the Rydell booth at Big O as well.
Yeah.
I remember. I just wanted to just like. Knock that thing down.
But you know what?
But I didn't.
If you knock it down, it's just going to get back up again. You're never going to keep it down.
You know, I get knocked down sometimes. But I get up again.
Yeah, you're never going to keep you down.
That's right. We're getting back into it. 1-0-0-6 Swifty with the star for Sacramento. 7-2-5 Sparkles Fantastic jamming it up for Red Stick.
Red Stick only with two blockers. They set up in a kind of a offensive formation, sitting up on either side. It doesn't really work out for them. Swifty gets out lead jammer for Sac.
Little Miss Maggot returns from penalty box. Swifty living up to that name, picking up 4 more points.
Yeah, Swifty able to really grab those edges, and now they're opting to run it long again.
4 points picked up by Sparkles Fantastic on her way through.
Forearm penalty sending Narnar Jinx to the box. Swifty choosing to run this one and run up that score.
Gotta get them perks. Gotta make that bread.
Yeah, at this point of the game, I mean, is it necessarily worth it? You gotta play a few more games this weekend.
Like, okay, I'm not a derby coach, but if I was ahead by 100, I would be focusing as hard as I could on just protecting the points that I have, like keeping that score differential high.
Yeah, and
as opposed to giving the other team an opportunity
right?
to rack them up.
And as
I'm
a
with you
jammer,
on
if we're ahead by this much, I don't really want to work that hard if I got to play a higher seed in my next game. So not quite sure what the strategy is here to keep on going with it.
That's right. Whoever wins this plays Evil tomorrow at 10 a.m.
And Evil coming in the third seed. Sacramento did beat Evil by 2 points at the Big O, but they're going to for sure
Such
want some revenge.
Biter.
Yeah, that was a nail biter. Went back and forth, back and forth.
And that jam comes to a conclusion. 8 points total picked up by Red Stick, 10 points by Sacramento. Number 15, Trip Hazard on the line now for Red Stick with 108. Namaste putting on the star for Sacramento.
Namaste actually hits the back of Fun Size there and takes advantage of the momentary destruction of the wall to get lead.
And Trip Hazard has passed the start at 8-9 Princess Lay and Anya. And Namaste gets in, calls it off, picking up 4 points on her way out. Machu Picchu stepping up to the jam line for Red Stick. You know, since we started talking about Machu and all those penalties she got, she hasn't gotten a single one. Of course,
true.
Now that we've said it, the announcer curse will happen.
It will obviously happen.
Number 18, Body, also up to the jam line.
Only person in jammer trouble, or excuse me, trouble of fouling out here is con artist on Sacramento.
Sitting at 6. And Body is through to get that lead. Machu also through.
Pack is really separated there. Red Stick, I think the pivot there was trying to kind of funnel. It didn't really work because the pack was really spread out, and they left that inside really open for Body to do a nice little apex hop.
Now back on the line, 1415 Bird Dog jamming for Sacramento. This is, I think, her third time on the line. Against 725, Sparkles Fantastic. Second time?
Second time, yeah.
All right, Bobby Narco says second time. Maybe the second time's the charm.
She had a pretty good first jam. There goes. Announcer curse. She gets a forearms penalty. So this is going to be a power jam for Red Stick.
Yep, and Sparkles Fantastic is your lead jammer. Bird Dog has gotten a penalty both times she's jammed.
You know, second time, you know, if this game goes another 10 minutes, then, you know, maybe that third time will be a charm. Forearms penalty sends.
Little Miss Maggot.
Yes, to the box, and another Sacramento blocker to the box.
And Sparky is through, putting up 4 points.
Bird Dog comes in, evades a hit from Fun Size. Fun Size recycles, but goes out of bounds on the last hit.
And that is the end of the jam. Sparky, or Fun Size rather, calling it off. 4 points picked up, 4 more points picked up by Red Stick.
WFTDA Continental Cups are brought to you by the Radar Halo. Switch to the Radar Halo today and see why the Halo is the best-selling wheel in Derby.
It's some good wheels, y'all.
I love those wheels.
Number 15, Trip Hazard with the star for Red Stick. 108, Namaste jamming for Sacramento.
Red Stick trying an interesting formation, setting one near the line, then coming together with two on either of the lines. But effectively holding with two.
Little Miss Maggot coming out of the box and just devastating, allowing Trip Hazard to get through, pick up the lead. That is back-to-back leads for Red Stick for the first time in this half.
Ooh. And she does a little hop there. It was an apex jump, but it was enough of a hop to get her through and then only leave her with one more. Gets four and calls it off.
5-1-1, Machu Picchu with the star once again for Red Stick up against 1006 Swifty for Sacramento.
Now, last time Swifty is out, they ran it long against the jammer. Let's see what they want to do here.
Now, less than 3 minutes left in the game.
Swifty stuck up in the back against a three wall. Legal contact, sending keys to the box. Lead jammer for Swifty. And a star pass now going to Princess Leonania.
Got number 89. That is the fourth time Princess has received the star. Oh, and Swifty is off to the box, so this is now a power jam for Red Stick, and it will go its full 2 minutes.
This is going to run this one such that we have 1 minute left to go in the game.
In the jam. 2 minutes left on the period, so this will be the probably the next to last jam.
Machu Picchu going to the box. That's her sixth as a blocker now. Oh, a nice offense there. Fun size running the in and out. Princess Leidania getting through, getting the full four.
Gorgeous footwork on the part of Princess. And Swifty is out of the box and picking up points far in the sky for Sacramento.
Princess now working on a second scoring pass. Excuse me, a third scoring pass at this point.
That is correct. Swifty's on her second scoring pass.
Sacramento shorting up some offense from fun size, trying to run back. High block sending Naka to the box from Sacramento. Jam comes to its natural conclusion. Swifty is able to pick up three more. And Sacramento takes a timeout. Okay.
You know, I don't know what they're at. Maybe Sacramento really kind of wants Red Stick to go up in the rankings more so they can play him again. Maybe they're having such a good time. They want to do it over. I don't know.
You know, it's that. You know, I don't know what Coach Master Hayter is thinking here and what's going through his head. Extending this one, you know, adding those a few more seconds. I mean, they were going to have another jam to end the game in any case. But maybe they think they can run up this differential a bit more. But it's at this point, I mean, this is an elimination tournament. So, you know, if you have to go against Evil's going to be coming in fresh. They're not going to have, they had the bye in the first round. And they're going to want to get Sacramento back for that big O loss.
And it is going to be North Star versus Red Stick tomorrow for game 9.
If you missed that North Star versus Team United game, once the archives are posted, you got to check it out. North Star coming from behind, taking the lead in a huge jam there by Karma. Karma Electra, 28-point jam, gave Team United that game.
725 Sparkle's fantastic jamming against Ariel the Twister. Ariel the Twister gets a track cut and Sparky gets the lead.
Ariel the Twister, typically a pretty clean hitter. Oh, look, looks like that. Oh, wow. Okay, so that was judged to be not a penalty. And Ariel the Twister falling down and able to paw back up with one hand. You want to talk about some core work? That's some core work.
Both jammers picking up 4 points. Sparky chooses to call it off with no seconds left. That is the end of our game. Oh, we got an official review being called on the part of Red Stick. So this, we will have one more jam.
Yeah, it has zero is on the clock, but if they judge this to have happened prior to that game clock running out, then we'll have another jam. Believe that is how the rules work. So Red Stick here wanting to have another one, trying to shore up some of that.
Clearly not using the official review just as a timeout, as we can see the coaches talking to Dr. Math.
Although the coaches, only one of the coaches is in there. The Red Stick coach now coming and captain now coming to the center. Wild speculation, Heisenberg. What is the official review about?
Oh, definitely about that track cut that wasn't a track cut.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely, for sure.
Some weirdness happening there.
That was some weirdness happening.
Might have been judged to be a track cut by one official, overruled by the other. we'll see what happens as a result of the review. Up next,
we've got Jet City versus Adelaide at 4 p.m. Mountain Time. All right, we're going to wait for our alt ref to let us know what was up.
So the Jet City versus Adelaide game that's coming next is going to be simulcast on Twitch.
Oh, yeah.
And so that's going to be great. So they're going to run a Twitch stream. So if you have friends, relatives, enemies.
Frenemies.
Crushes, hey, that you want to check out Roller Derby, send them the Twitch link to that game and get them. It's going to be some exciting action. Jet City from Everett, Washington versus Adelaide from down under. You're going to want to really check that out and get anybody that you think would be remotely interested in Roller Derby to watch it as well. And just for your information, FYI, there's going to be a Twitch stream for every game, one of these, in each of these postseason tournaments coming up.
All right, Red Stick challenged the points and won. So Sacramento is actually losing points from that jam.
Oh, wow. So that successful review with 1 second left on the clock, you got to buy the coach from Red Stick a beverage of their choice, because that was a nice call there.
And up to the jam line for this final jam, number 15, Trip Hazard, or as her league mate Comet Kazi says, more like Skip Hazard. Am I right?
Am I right? And Skip's right on the outside line. The jammer.
What a body. Sorry, what a body with the star for Sacramento.
Two in a row for Red Stick. Body coming through. Now working on the pass. You're going to know Hazard probably going to want to run this long.
4 points picked up by both jammers. Oh, yeah, Red Stick is out for all the points at this point. They're definitely not going to call it off unless they do.
Bodies at the floor.
Also, you can see on their new jerseys, they have a Red Stick on the sides. Oh, and this is now a power jam as Body picks up a track cut.
Oh, gosh. Some bad news bears there for Sacramento. And Hazard getting through, avoids a hit from Rhodes Warrior. Rhodes Warrior gets a track cut. Shrunken back there by Sacramento. Hazard's going to take advantage of this.
Yep, she's got 12 points so far. Takes a huge hit from 970, Narnar Jinx.
Narnar known for those giant hits there.
Those gnarly hits.
Hey.
Hey.
All right, both jammers back in the action. Four points picked up by Body. Four more points picked up by Trip Hazard.
Hazard looks to the bench. Can I call it off? They want her to keep on going. Get these points. And a track cut. Body to the box. Hazard trying to make the most out of these 10 seconds left on the clock.
So what you're saying is you let the body hit the box.
Let the you know, I think that's absolutely right. And Hazard picking up the full four on that last one. 20-point jam to 8 for Red Stick.
Red Stick's highest scoring jam of the game.
Yes, in Deedly Hazenberg. So what a nice way to
end this.
177 to Red Stick. Still falling to Sacramento, but you got to feel, they feel good about that.
Oh, absolutely.
That's a nice way to end the game, to really ensure that you minimize that point differential and try to get those ranking points.
And that is our official final score, 259 to 177 in favor of Sacramento.
So Sacramento is going to go on at 10 a.m. tomorrow, 10 a.m. Orem time, going to play Evil. Meanwhile, Red Stick going to go on to play the loser of game one. That is North Star at 2 p.m. said, tomorrow. So you're going to want to check those out. There's going to be some really great games. What do you have to say, Hazenberg?
This, honestly, Red Stick may have lost on this one, and they're my home league, so I do have a little investment in wanting them to win, but win or lose, they play like champions on this one.
Oh, absolutely.
And Sacramento just put on an incredible game out here, putting on a clinic, really. And Red Stick doing the arch on the track right now as Sacramento comes through. That's a class move.
Absolutely. Sacramento coming out big. I really liked how they were working with a variety of jammers. I was kind of wondering what they were going to do and how they were going to go with it. Ariella Twister nursing that injury, coming up big, but also expanding their jammer rotation out to Swifty, out to Body, out to Namaste, and that defense really being able to hold her. So if you see, the dogs are out on the track running with their owners. What is that?
Hashtag Derby Dogs.
Hashtag Derby Dogs. Miss Willa Dean running out there.
Absolutely. Thank you guys so much for coming and watching this game. Stick around for Jet City versus Adelaide. My name is Hazenberg.
I'm Kate Silver.
We are out.